Would you care for some coffee, Anson?
No, thank you, sir.
How about a sandwich?
I don't think so, sir.
Oh, come on. It's been hours. You must be hungry.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Were you ever married?
Never had the time.
Don't you ever get lonely?
For ambitious Starfleet officers, there are certain costs involved. I must be cautious of long-term commitments, Wesley.
No problem. Where women are concerned, I am in complete control.
Really? I always rather had to work at that.
Have you always been so disciplined?
Good Lord, no. If I was, I wouldn't have this problem.
I don't understand.
Well, I was a young Starfleet officer, not many years older than you are now. Top of my academy class. Green as hell. And oh so cocky. Too cocky, as it turned out.
What happened?
Several friends and I were on leave at Farspace Starbase Earhart. There was little more than a galactic outpost in those days.
Was this before the Klingons joined the Federation?
That's right. Well, my mates and I were at the Bonstell Recreation Facility, which was something of a dead rough crossroads at the time, filled with an assorted bunch of galactic riffraff, when a trio of Norsecons came in. They were clearly spoiling for a confrontation with a group of fresh-faced Starfleet officers such as ourselves. Well, everyone in the group had the good sense to give these Norsecans a wide berth, stand off. Everyone, that is, except me. I stood toe-to-toe with the worst of the three. And I told him what I thought of him, his pals, his planet, and I possibly made some passing reference to his questionable parentage. And the next thing I knew, all three of them were on me, and I was fighting for my life. I was actually doing quite well for a while, too.
You fought them and won?
I had this one Norsecan down in this somewhat devious joint lock when, unbeknownst to me, one of his chums drew his weapon and impaled me through the back. Curious sensation, actually. Not much pain. Shock, certainly, at the sight of serrated metal sticking through my chest. Certain giddy warmth. In fact, I do actually remember that I laughed out loud. Well, it pierced my heart, of course. In fact, if we'd not been so near to a medical facility, I would surely have died.
Really? Then what happened?
Nothing. I was no hero, Wesley. I was an undisciplined, loud-mouthed, opinionated young man who was way out of his league. Learned a very hard, very painful lesson that day. But I learned it well. I hope you never have to learn it the same way. And care for another sandwich?
Please.